I'm pretty sure this is coming to you on Thanksgiving, so like happy Thanksgiving, I guess. And let's talk about books. Hi, hello, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Alex, and today is our December maybes. If you're new here, the maybe series is a video I do at the end of the month that where I talk about books I might read for the upcoming month. Sometimes they're themed, sometimes they're not. Sometimes I read a lot and sometimes I read a little. So I definitely don't read all the books on this list. This is just kind of the list that I work off of. Before we get started, make sure you hit all the buttons down below so you know when I'm posting. I post every week, even when it's a holiday. Here I am posting for you. So yeah, make sure you follow so you don't miss anything. So, when I sat down to do my maybes list, I was sitting here thinking, what do I want to read for December? Well, let's be honest, I have not read a lot for November yet. And I know November's like over, and I still haven't read that much. I've been really, really busy with freelancing, and also I've been busy trying not to be a sad person. It takes a lot of energy to not be a sad person. So, yeah, that's what I've been doing for November, and basically, November's over, and yeah, that's where I am. A couple years ago, this was not intentional, but I started reading a lot of like winter themed books in December. I don't know if it was just like we had a lot of snow going on, and I always just kind of wanted to get into this winter-esque feel, but like the last couple years, when I look back at the books I've read in December, they've all kind of had this like winter-ish vibe to them. So I was like, let's just see if we can keep that up for this December. Let's get into the list, okay, and we can chat along the way. The first book I'm going to talk to you about today is Winter Solstice by Elin Hildebrand. If you haven't read any of her books, she writes these like really great romance books. Beach Reads, like she's kind of famous for Beach Reads, but I really love her. Like she writes these like really complicated romance stories that just, I don't know, I like it. Anyway, this is book four of the Winter Street series. For four Decembers now, I have read the Winter Street series. And this is the last book in the series, so that means this year is my last year reading them, which is like, it kind of makes me a little sad because I love these books. If you've seen that movie, The Family Stone, it's a lot like that. Like the dynamics between the brothers and sisters and the parents and everything, like that's what it reminds me of. And if you haven't seen The Family Stone, just watch it. Just watch it, okay? That is like a staple film for me for the holidays. This book series just reminds me so much of that family that I just love it. I love that this is the Quinn family, and they own a little inn on Nantucket Island. And just the dynamics, the relationships in this story, like it's just drama all the time, and it's great. So this is the last book in that series. Like, I'll definitely read this in December because this is kind of my December tradition. And after this December, I'll have to find a new tradition because this is the last one in the series. So I'm gonna try not to think about it too much. But yeah, that's this book. So when I sat down and I was like, I want books that are like winter-ish. A lot of the books that kept popping up were like holiday books. I've probably told y'all this before. I don't like the holidays. Like my least favorite time of year, and Christmas is by far like my least favorite holiday. I do not really get into Christmas. Like, I begrudgingly put my tree up. I just don't get into it. Like, it's just a really hard time of year. Like, financially, it's hard. The weather usually really sucks. My kids get super stir crazy. You always feel like this pressure to like perform at the holidays, and it's a lot. It's so much work doing the holidays, and I just don't like doing any of it. But because I have kids and stuff, like I do all of this stuff, but it's very draining for me. And so when I was sitting here, like thinking about winter books and stuff, the last thing I wanted to read about was Christmas crap, okay, or holiday stuff, okay? I'm so sorry, but no, when I was like winter aesthetic reading and everything that was popping up was like holiday romance, no, 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 no. That's not what we're going for. What I'm going for is secluded cabin in the woods and there's a mass murderer. Post-apocalyptic, snowed in Alaska. Desperation. That's what I was going for. So that might give you a little hint to how this list kind of went. The next book on the maybes list is The Killing Lessons by Saul Black. Pretty much everything I described. I didn't really look too hard into this book because the cover kind of said it all for me. It's gonna be a forest, there's gonna be some killing, and yeah, gonna be snowy. I think that ticks all the boxes, right? It's definitely not gonna be holiday fun. So yeah, it went on the list. I did make an exception for this next book, okay? It's called Santa's Broken Toy by Una Grace. It drops, if it's Thanksgiving week, I think it just came out. And it is smutty Christmas biker Santa novella. Spicy Christmas is what it is. Yeah, I guess it does kind of have like the Christmassy vibe to it, but like, look at the cover. That's not any Christmas that I experienced. So this is probably the only one that's like happy-ish Christmas, and it's only happy Christmas because she's getting her bell rung a lot. Yeah, that's on the list. And Una Grace is an indie author, and I believe this is her debut novel, so I'm really excited to read this one. Next book is One by One by Ruth Ware. Again, the cover told me a lot more about the vibe that I was going for. Dark, twisty, psychological, thriller, in the winter. That's what we're going for. That's what we're going for. And Ruth Ware, like, I've read Ruth Ware a bunch of times, and she's never disappointed me. So, I mean, yeah, One by One, I'm pretty sure it sounds like And Then There Were None. So, yeah. It fits, right? The next one is Bury Your Dead by Louise Penny. At this point, I had been digging through a bunch of lists because, again, I was trying to slog through all the Happy Holidays winter stuff to get to more of, like, the deeply disturbing winter stuff. And I can't really remember what this one is about, but I feel like it's about a cabin in a woods that are snowed in, and there's basically these two guys that are going around serial murdering people. I feel like if that's not this one, then it's another one. I'm sorry. They've all blurred together, but basically it fits in the brief. Cold, isolated, death. Fits in there. So, of course, it went on the list. I may not really remember what it's about, but it looked interesting. Okay, the next one is called The Christmas Murder Game by Alexandra Benedict. Okay, this one I do remember, and it sounds so much fun. Like, basically, it's a scavenger hunt murder mystery that happens at a mansion. So I guess the way the description read was like the family gets together and does these little scavenger hunts every year and then they win something. Well, this time the scavenger hunt, they win the deed to this house, like the mansion, like the family mansion or something like that. Apparently there's a lot of like really bad blood between a lot of the family members because, you know, why not? And this year people, if you don't make it to like the next clue or whatever, you die. I mean, color me intrigued. That sounds like a blast. I'm really excited about this one. I hope that I actually have time to read it because this sounds really cool. Like, right up my alley. This is hitting the brief like all the way. I'm excited about this one. The last book I'm going to talk to you about today is Five Total Strangers by Natalie D. Richards. Okay, so apparently this girl is trying to get home. Her mom, there's like someone's died or something like that, and they're like, you have to get home right away. Okay, yeah. So she goes to the airport, There's a huge blizzard coming in. All the planes are grounded. So a couple of the other people that are on her flight are like, let's all rent a car together and drive. Horrible idea, by the way. Oh yeah, the weather's too bad for an airplane, so let's drive in the middle of a flippin' snowstorm? Are you crazy? No, I'm just gonna miss it. I'm just gonna miss it. Whatever it is, y'all don't need me there, okay? Really remember the blurb that well, but it was like, I guess the main character thought that all of these people knew each other, but apparently they didn't, so none of them know each other, and then apparently someone in the car turns up to be like a murderer or something. I don't know. At first blush, it sounds like it could be really interesting. Then, like, as I looked at it, as I like was listening to myself talk to you about it just now, I was like, man, this feels a lot like that book, No Exit, that I read last year that was extremely disappointing. This feels a lot like that. So the ratings are really good though, so I don't know. I think maybe if I have time, but like I said, it fits the brief though. I mean, look at the cover. I mean, obviously that's what we're going for. That is my maybes list for December. I really don't know what December's gonna look like for me. I always end up saying that I wanna get a lot of reading done in December, but and I always tell myself, like, keep the holidays low-key, try not to outdo yourself, try to protect your mental health, and set up boundaries, blah, 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 all of that stuff. And I never do it. I never do it. And December always ends up being super hectic and super stressful and busy for no flipping good reason. So, no idea what my reading is going to look like for December. So, let's just keep our hopes up, I guess. I don't know. We'll just see. We'll just see. Have you read any of these books that are on the list? And if you have, and you really like them, and you want to, you know, let me know, choose this one instead of that one, leave me a comment. Before you go, make sure you hit all the buttons down below so you know when I'm posting. I post every week. If you're celebrating Thanksgiving today, happy Thanksgiving. If you're not celebrating Thanksgiving today, happy Thursday. I hope you guys will come back and check out all of the December content I'm going to come up with, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!